Good evening, everyone. My topic for today is significance of orodental tracing in identification of human body. So starting with introduction. Yes, ma'am, next slide. Starting with introduction, what is identification? So basically, identification is an establishment of individuality of a person, either dead or living. So when is identification required? It is required in victims of mass disasters like earthquakes, tsunami, and many others. Criminals who are absconding, missing persons, monetary cases, civil litigation cases, and closures. Next slide, ma'am. Forensic odontology and its applications. So forensic odontology is that branch of forensic medicine which in the interest of justice deals with the proper handling and examination of dental evidence and with the proper evaluation and presentation of the dental findings. Its applications are, it is used in the age estimation, it is used in the identification of found human remains, identification in mass disasters, it is also used in assessment of bite mark injuries, assessment of cases of abuse and civil cases involving malpractice. Ma'am, next slide, please. Dental identification. So dental identification of human beings, it plays an important role in criminal, monetary, social, burial, and many other cases. So the main form of dental identification, one such form is comparative dental identification. Comparative dental identification includes that is the postmortem dental remains can be compared with the antemortem dental records. So the postmortem dental remains, it includes that the forensic odontologist, it includes a charting and the written descriptions of the dental radiographs and the charting of the oral cavity is done. And antemortem dental records, it includes the numerous dental treatments which have undergone and along with the preservation of it. So the steps of comparative dental identification are, the first step is oral autopsy. So oral autopsy, it helps to make a proper postmortem dental record. Here, incision is done, that is, it is done along the angle of the mandible to the tragus of the ear. Here, the sectioning of the muscles and the ligaments of the temporomandibular joint is done. Traction of the mouth is done. And the visualization of the oral and oral arches, that is upper and lower dental arches, done. If there is any developmental anomalies related to shape, size of the teeth, then it is marked. And then the second step is securing the antemortem records. The third step is comparison between antemortem and postmortem records. The last step is conclusion and final reports. So both the reports are compared and then the evaluation is done. The antemortem records, it includes the written notes, study cast, radiographs of the patient, that is to confirm the identity. Next slide, ma'am. Types of identification. So according to American Board of Forensic Odontology, the four types are, the first one, positive identification, where the antemortem and postmortem data matches sufficiently, that is, no discrepancy is found. The second, possible identification. Here, the quality of either evidence is not possible to establish the identity unambiguously. The third one, insufficient evidence, where the available information is insufficient for conclusion. The last, exclusion. Here, the antemortem and the postmortem data are clearly inconsistent. So these are the types of identification which helps to make a proper conclusion. Next slide, sir. Newer identification techniques, it includes the postmortem dental profiling, other innovative methods, and role of DNA in dental identification. So the postmortem dental profiling, here the forensic dentist, it produces a sketch or a picture of the facial features of the person, and it is known as dental profiling. It is performed when the antemortem records are unavailable or virtually no clue exists. And it includes a triad of information, that is ethnic origin, gender, and age. Other innovative methods includes the label dentures, which may be used in identification, orthodontic appliances used by the patients, The Ruge pattern of the palate on the maxillary cast is compared with the recovered human remains. Role of DNA in dental identification. So here, the teeth plays an important role because they are an excellent source of DNA material as they are resistant to environmental assaults. After the body is decomposed, the dental tissues like enamel, dentin, pulp, they survive. So the DNA is extracted from that and it is used in the dental identification and it plays a very major role. Next slide. So the last conclusion is that forensic dentistry has a very crucial role in identification of those individuals who cannot be identified visually or by any other means. And the unique nature and the structure of the dental tissues play an important role. That is, the teeth being the hardest substance in the body, they survive in most of the conditions. And the size, shape, and arrangement of teeth differs for everyone. That is, no two humans have the identical dentition relative. So at last, there should be maintenance of dental records, cast, x-rays, sample tissues, so that the preserved materials may be used in the identification of diseased individuals. These are my references. Thank you.